Pierre, welcome. Let's talk about circularity. What role does it have to play in the climate conversation?
So circularity is certainly a very large role because one thing we've come to all realize during COP is that energy is going to be the limiting factor for decarbonization. And in the case of aluminum, circularity means saving 95% of the energy and the greenhouse gases that you would emit with primary aluminum. Mm. So it's a massive benefit for decarbonization.
How do we scale? What are the challenges that you face?
So today, scaling is limited by three things. The first one is innovation. In order to improve circularity, we need to be able to sort and segregate the different scrap alloys to avoid downcycling. Mm-hmm. And while there are promising technologies, they're not fully scaled up yet. The second one is scrap availability. We need to make sure that scrap is not disappearing and that we can increase the size of the pie. And the third one is policy, which has to do a little bit with the previous point, but we need governments to help us make sure that, for instance, used beverage cans mm-hmm. are not going to be landfilled, but properly collected and recycled.
You mentioned innovations at the top there. Which have the most potential, do you think, to really unlock this industry?
So we're working with a number of different technology providers, specifically around sorting and segregation. We have seen laser-induced base spectroscopy, or LIBS, mm-hmm. Being very promising for sorting. We've also seen AI being very useful combined with cameras to be able to learn from the different types of scrap that the cameras see. Yep. And decide which one is going to be good for recycling and which one is not. And so I think, you know, AI is going to certainly bring a lot of good things for scalability.
Yeah, thank you so much.